So for many people, their impersonalism may not, they may have an impersonal belief system, but their impersonal philosophical orientation or belief system, that may not obstruct them from coming to Krishna as much as our condemning them for their impersonalism. Because they may say, oh, so many teachers, this teacher and that teacher are talking about impersonalism. Are you saying they're all wrong? And that might actually obstruct them much more. Now, they might have gone to some, they might have chanted some Om mantra or done something, and they might have got some experience by that. And that experience is what is taking them forward. Now, that experience might just be some sattvic experience, might be just some preliminary experience of spiritual reality. And devotional experiences can be far richer and deeper and sweeter. But instead of giving them the experience of Krishna, we start combating their philosophy. And that simply alienates them because they have some experience better than the normal experience. So imagine this is a normal day-to-day materialistic experience. And this is the experience of some peace which might come because of some experience of something spiritual, even if it's impersonal. Now this is a bhakti experience. Now we start criticizing that impersonalism is wrong. Impersonalists are wrong. Now what has happened is that is their experience that has made them explore life's spiritual domain. And if we try to critique their experience, then what happens? They see it as, this is what has worked for me. How dare you say it's wrong? So rather than criticizing people for their impersonalism, we try to give them an experience of Krishna. And if you give them that experience, then they will naturally move forward. They will come up. If somebody is in cold and they have just found one thin, tattered sheet which is protecting them from the cold. Well, it's not really protecting them very well from the cold, but it is giving them some protection. And if we tell them, you know, this is a torn, thin sheet, what's the use? Just throw it away. No, this is protecting me from cold. Our intention might be, I'll give you a nice, thick, soft comforter. But they have not experienced that comforter. They have only experienced whatever relief comes from that thin sheet. So if we try to pull away that sheet from them, they may fight with it for their life and then just go away from us. So instead of trying to pull away that sheet, we need to focus on putting the comforter around them. And once we put the comforter around them, hey, this is so cozy. This is so pleasant. And do I really need that sheet? No, I don't. Then put it aside. So putting the comforter around them is like giving them the experience of Krishna and trying to pull out the earlier tattered sheet from them. That is like trying to counter their existing philosophical ideas. So more important than countering wrong philosophy is giving people the right experience. And once they get the right experience, they will gradually come toward the right philosophy.